Alright, here we are. You are now watching the Blender Data Tips and Tricks, and this, of course, is lesson number 61. And in this lesson, we're going to see how we can rig a car. So this process is available for any car, which means if it's low poly or high poly, is the same process occur. So we will let's. I have added this one, and I want to clear the parent, and here clear the parent and. Try to start from scratch. So we have a car. Basically, you may get the car which have the wheels attached to the car. So what you will make is to separate each wheel and make the origin to here, for example. So we will select this one and make cursor selected, and Control Shift C to make the origin to the 3D cursor. And after that, we will for the same four wheels, Shift S cursor selected, and again Shift S cursor to selected, and here also we will alright. And after that, I want to start the rigging. This is the material car. And the car was material, and it's low poly, which is around maybe close to 900. And I will add to an MBT, which is an a cube, and we can select this one and make the cursor selected and add an a cube, and this cube will be scaled in the x-axis and scale in Y to be like this. And after that, I will select the car and select this one and Control B key transform and select this one and going to name it the main body. And it's main body one because I have two car in this file, which is this first one, and I want to show you what you will get here. So we will get this wheel running, and we can also rotate this one to in the z-axis, like the driver here. And also I will select this one and add an MBT plane axis and the scale 0.7, cursor selected, and add an plane axis and the scale 0.7, add an plane axis scale 0.7 and scale 0.7. And after that, I want to select each wheel and parent to this MBT axis, and after that I want to select all these and parent to the main cube. Then we want to add our first animation, so we will select this one and going here to this panel and Control D single from target. And after that, I want to go here in the graph editor and select the driver and select this rotation, select the drivers, and we want to save, and we want to go from single property to transform, and from the Y location local, and this will be var, and this will be var multiplied by -1.25. Alright, so let's see what we will get if we move here. It should work. Let's see what we will get. I think that I will select the MBT and go again to the gravitator, and I think we must choose the main body 2, and here we are, which is this is an invalid, and a var in small. It's case sensitive, we will continue to this one. And let's move in the Y, and it's run correctly. So I will select this one and copy the driver, and then I will paste in this place. So I will paste for all other places, and we are now done for the first part. So here we are. And for the direction, I will make an ablain, and let's scale in X, extrude in Y, and scale in X 0.5 maybe, and then I will move in the Z. I want to make an for this plane. Let's make a material. Because I want to see in the viewport when I put this car into the scene. And for a moment it will be like this. And in the viewport it will be like this. Alright, that's fine. I will select the first wheel and copy rotation from the direction 2. So I will name this direction 2. And let's copy the rotation from direction 2. And now we are done for this one. Let's also control link. And I will also add an object constraint, copy rotation for this one, direction 2, and disable for X and Y. So let's see what we have. So we are moving in this direction, and we are moving in this direction, and rotating around the Z. I want to select and make the origin to the 3D cursor, and finally I want to parent to the object. So we have this one. Alright, finally there is something I want to talk about. If you want to restore it to the origin, the original rotation, you must restore by Alt R. I will try, I didn't have tried it before, but I will try to make a suspension for the ground. So I will scale it in the X and scale in Y 20 time. And let's make here few adjustment. I want to make some bump for the ground to test the suspension, as I have mentioned before. Alright, so I will select the whole body and moving to be here, and I will select this one and add another constraint, which is a shrink wrap. So it will be shrinked to the ground. This will be called ground. And let's select this one and object constraint to the ground, and let's move distance like this. And for the all, it will be shrink wrap ground 0.4. And finally, for this one, the same shrink wrap and ground and point 0.41. All right, so let's test Z. Let's move in the Y and it should work moving in the Y. Alright, so I have forget to apply the scale for this one, so it's there was an delay in the movement. So let's move here, and as you can see, it's suspension. As you can see, this is the perfect that we are looking for. And let's move again here. Alright. Let's move here also, and it's work successfully. And I think it didn't fail up to this moment. But if we add here an bump, which may be more, so let's test the three ground bumps. So it's work up to this moment, and it's working here. So it seems that it works correctly as we expect. I think let's see from this side, moving in the Y, it's working here, working here, and it's working in all directions. So I hope you enjoy this lesson that have been concluded for this lesson. So let's finish in this lesson, and I will see you in the next tutorial.